There we are. Okay, let's go. Okay, thank you very much, Greg, for the introduction. Thank you, judges. I appreciate you being here and the whole audience. I am so excited to be here. Thank you very much. I am really pleased to present my business. It is called Credo Studio, and we teach visual and performing arts. It's a center for the arts in San Juan Bautista. My name, Credo, is a Latin word that means I believe. And the peacock represents freedom of self-expression. So the purpose of my studio is for the freedom of artistic expression. Credo Studio, a place for your passion. My name is Ramona Hill, and I live and work in San Juan Bautista, which is a quaint, beautiful, wonderful mission town. I love it. And it's a tourist town. It attracts thousands of visitors every year. The problem is that for the residents, there's not that much business focus on our residents. Most of the businesses focus on tourism. And so this lack of focus on resident families leaves our youth unengaged. I am concerned about my youth and that this lack of activity could put them at risk. And so I already know, I have children myself, I know they're bored, so I don't want them to be getting into trouble. With Credo Studio, we have a solution that focuses on our kids instead of tourism. My studio is conveniently located within a 10-minute walk from anywhere in town, easy to get to, and my program is affordable and engaging. This list displays my commitment to legitimize my business. I know that as a place where there will be minors, I will be scrutinized. I plan to be prepared for that by vetting my staff. My facility, I say that it's multi-purpose. I can provide opportunity for teachers in my community, students, and artists, because I have classrooms, I have a gallery, and a performance venue. I've been market-driven from the very beginning, from even before the beginning. I was asking people what they needed in San Juan. These are actual quotes that I heard at my grand opening in January, and I have had continuous events since then, and I have continual community feedback. And so all feedback helps me to refine my operation, whether that is what someone wants, what someone doesn't want, how they experience my thoughts. Although I do provide programming for all ages, my primary target market will be school-aged youth. And so I will be marketing to their parents. And the top three are the demographics of that group. For people that are in the lower end of the income scale, I am seeking scholarship funding. Those bottom two are psychographics. And it's important that, that I mention that we're rural area residents because we value open space. We value that opportunity for our kids to get their hands in the dirt, and I have a community garden. I will have programming out there. This is the breakdown of the market within a 15-mile radius. The population that I include in my total available market are San Juan Bautista, Aronis, Prunedale, and portions of Hollister and Gilroy combined. My segmented addressable market is the combined population of my two local school districts. And I'm estimating my share of market at about 5%. I hope to get that. I hope to get more. And this chart compares Credo Studio to my most established competitors that are in Hollister, California. I'm the only studio that has this full range of diversity, and that includes three categories that none of my competitors has. This is partly a survival tactic, because since I am in a very defined market, I aim to have something for everybody in my area. The most important thing that I would like to say about my pricing is that I have based my class cost on a standardized hourly rate. I want my cost to be understandable to my clients. I sell memberships, so they can use a membership across all my departments, and that pricing goes across all the classes. And also, I want it to be easy to budget. This is about proceeds. I expect all of my expenses to be covered by my sales. This is illustrating that there are things that I would hope to be covered by grant money. That would include scholarship and community projects. My crown jewel project is to build a bandstand in San Juan Bautista, and to institute a Music in the Park program, and that would be for public use. I could see us doing political forums on the standstand, you know, old-fashioned style. So I would expect those kinds of things to be done with grant money. And the 5% of self-funding is to indicate my understanding that additional personal investment may be required. I expect to break even about a year from now. I've been open for 3 months, so I have my fixed expenses, real figures on that. My expense line includes a increase on my variables. It includes starting to repay my investment next year. And then my revenue line is conservatively based on studio share of customer hours, that is student hours per month. I will have additional streams of income from workshops, events, recording, and other services. There's a lot that will be going on. And this chart is based on the same figures as the previous one, showing the net result. I show profitability next year. And then by the third year, I expect to be established enough to see a leap in income and to be holding my expenses under tight control. My instructors will be independent contractors. Their pay will come as a portion of the student fees. And also, materials will largely be covered by students as well. It's art. They buy paper, they buy paint. We are already through the call phase at Credo Studio. One of the most important developments is that we participate in this community-wide art event every month called First Saturday San Juan. And what we do at Credo Studio is have an artist reception and an open mic the first Saturday of every month. This is open to the public. And so then we have that art display all month, art for sale there. We are now in the walk phase. The most important thing for me going on in this phase is that I'm upgrading the website that will relaunch by the end of the month and be fully functional. I have a software that's managing all the back office that will be accessible, so people can register and pay online through my website. The other great thing is I have a PowerPoint, so I will be taking this on the road. And my final run phase, I'm already forging relationships with local professionals and politicians. There's a new commissioner on the Parks and Rec in Hollister, and I've already been before my county supervisors. So that's in the works. My summer camp starts next month. That's a collaboration between the city, the library, and myself. And then I'm developing my after-school and homeschool enrichment programs to launch in the fall. This is my team. They were attracted by the grand opening event, and they are all very experienced in their fields. So they already have community recognition. They all have the expertise and the community connections to drive my program development. And the very, very magical thing about my team is that by working at Credo, they're fulfilling their own dreams. I tell that story about my music director. He bought the software for our recording because he's motivated. So that's really exciting to have people so engaged. Credo Studio maintains a membership to the Fractured Atlas. They are a national nonprofit art service organization that helps art businesses acquire grants. So as a member, I have access to grant money. They do require $1,000 seed money for any application. And so I can leverage funds that I receive up to less than $10,000. They have grants up to $1 million. Wow. These are my financial priorities. I need to have an ADA compliant bathroom, and as we reach capacity, I'll need more space to accommodate more students and to expand my program. The building I'm in does have a second story that has grand ballroom in it. I have my eye on up there. I'd like to get the adult art studio upstairs as well. And these are all important points that what these mean is that I plan and hope for Credo Studio to be in San Juan Bautista long-term to serve the community. And I'd like this to be a family-owned business that passes down through the generations. That's my plan. Thank you. I'm gonna give the mic. I still need it. Okay. Yes.
Just Very well done. Very great idea. So really nice. I had a question in terms of the activities that you're planning. I didn't see anything in terms of what were the primary, what the customers said, or whether you reached out and talked to your customers, future customers and present customers, about what kind of activities. And second, what is your competition?
Okay, so number one, to answer the question, I teach primarily is going to be classes. One thing will be an after-school program. There's a lot of interest in that. That I have already right now, I have a theater expression program for young children. I have a dance class, I have a music class, and I have some wellness classes. So that's already going on. We are going to develop more for the kids. What's happening right now is the records I have offering what they have to offer. That will be developed. And the second thing you asked, so my competition are studios in Hollister, and they are mostly single discipline. One is Inspire Theater Arts. They're mostly about theater, they have some music. And then there is Mr. O's Music School. And then there is, third one I had up there was the San Diego Arts Council. So that's the thing, is that they're all specific, and you know, that's pretty normal. But I understand I need to offer, you know, a lot. I'm in a small market.
But that might be why they succeed, because they're focused and you're going to spread yourself. Mm-hmm. Is that a worry?
Well, I don't really worry, because I'm going to have directors in all those departments. It is what is called an ambition. I've had that people say to me, this is so ambitious, and I'm saying, yeah, it is. It's an ambition, I admit that.
Yeah, the question about focus, follow on that. The notion that you're going to be doing discipline-oriented classes at the same time you do childcare. So there's a tension there that childcare can be a little bit more chaotic, and discipline classes tend to be episodic and structured. So I'm wondering, tease that apart. Is it just a licensing issue on childcare, or because you're going to have kids on facilities, or are you actually looking at saying to parents, we're providing childcare for your child from 3:30 to 6:30?
Mm-hmm. This is really funny. This is a comment that I got from the executive director of the YMCA, that basically all us people that do children's program are glorified babysitters. So that was a recommendation of a friend of mine who ran a childcare center. She just was suggesting it as, again, legitimizing, that if I am qualified as a child care provider, that I'm offering programming. So I don't know really how necessary that is. It was a suggestion that I haven't fully examined yet. The after school program would be the thing that's the most like child care, but everything else is classes. And it's also breaking down my schedule.
My question was is tied to schools. The first question, the first piece of that would be, what are you doing in relationship to local schools in terms of outreach? And the second is there an opportunity for you to actually provide services on premises at the schools, thereby getting away out, getting out of some facilities problems that you're likely to incur if you grow?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so with what my relationship with the schools right now is that I am allowed to pass information to you. So I can distribute flyers right in the backpacks. I actually, a couple of years ago, I came up with a concept to do what I called fitness club in school. And I offered it. I pitched it to them, I had the material, I was ready to go, and they said, do you have insurance? And I said, no. Well, another business owner had been doing dance classes on campus. She had a business with insurance. So now that I have that, I can go on campus. And I think there would be cases that I do that. I'm already doing volunteer things, like at my library in Hollister, where they just want to be coming for an hour, and I would do that as well. I've only, you know, been open, this is my third month. So, but I am doing a lot of outreach, a very lot. Thank you.
I had some questions about how you're going to grow. Year two to three, it looks like your income goes up pretty considerably, but your expenses are almost the same. And I'm thinking about, I have two kids who are 18, 16, who have been through dance classes and music classes for the last 12 years. There's a lot of money in kids, so I think that the opportunity that you're looking at has real potential. But the facility that you have, one is 500 square feet, one is 600 square feet, if you want to grow, you've got theater and music and dance, they're all going at the same time, you're going to run out of space.
I'm sorry, that's all the time we have.
My capacity is six classes a day, 16 each. And that would probably be 12 in the morning,